Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you 10 ways to quickly access an important folder on your Mac. MacMost is supported by more than 600 viewers just like you. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There, you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So sometimes you have a folder that is the most important folder. It's got the files in it for the project you're working on now, and you're constantly accessing it from the Finder, from different apps, in different situations. There are many ways to make this folder more easily accessible so you can quickly get to it in different situations. Probably the most obvious one is to use the dock. Let's use this Project A folder as an example. If I drag and drop that to the right side of the dock, so to the right of this last line that's there, I can put a folder there and it will appear there. I can click it to quickly see the items in it. If I control click it, I can change it from a fan view to a grid view to a list view. I like the list view most of all. I can click it there and see the files and the folders and files inside those folders as well. I could also go into options here and change it to display as a folder rather than a bunch of different icons. And you can always click on it and go to open in Finder to open up that folder. Now you can also easily set it to be in the favorites in the Finder sidebar. To do that, all you need to do is drag and drop it over into the Finder sidebar. Once you put it there, you have now access to that folder by just clicking on it and it will jump to that location. But you can also drag and drop files directly into the Finder sidebar there. If the folder is an iCloud Drive, you have the choice between putting it in favorites or you could also put it under iCloud here. Now when you add something to the Finder sidebar, it also appears in another location, and that's in Open and Save dialogs. So for instance, let's go to Text Edit here and I have a file I need to save. I'll go to File, Save, and you can see I get kind of a mini Finder window here, including the sidebar. And there is that folder since I put it under Favorites. I can click on it and I jump easily to that location. The same thing for when I go to open a new file. I get the Finder sidebar there and I can click on the folder to go right to it. Now you can also add folders to the toolbar at the top. The best way to do that is to create a new Finder window so you have two Finder windows open at the same time. It doesn't matter what you're looking at in the second Finder window because you're just going to use that to go to View and then Customize Toolbar. And then with the Toolbar Customization window open, you can then drag a folder from the other Finder window and stick it there in the toolbar. It appears there as a folder. I'll see it just as an icon, but I can select Icon and Text if I want to see the name as well. Then it will appear in all Finder windows. So I can close the second window here and I can see it there. I can click on it to quickly jump to that folder, but I could also drag and drop into it. Now I like to keep a nice clean desktop with no files on there. But you can put folders there. If you move a folder to the desktop, it actually moves it into the desktop folder. Instead, if you want to keep the folder where it is, in this case Project A is in the Documents folder, I can hold the Option and Command keys both down. And notice the cursor changes to this little curved arrow. If I drop it there, what I'm doing is creating an alias there. Notice Project A is still in the Documents folder, but I have an alias to it now on the desktop. I can double click on that to open up the folder and I can also drag and drop files to it. It's also handy when you're in an app to go to File, Save and then use the shortcut Command D to jump to the desktop and there you would see any aliases you have on the desktop as well. So now I can double click on the Project A folder to go into it. Now you can also simply make this folder your default folder for new Finder windows. So if I were to create a new Finder window, you can see here it goes to my home folder. But I can go to Finder Preferences and under General I can change New Finder Window Show to anything I want. Right now it's set to the Home folder, I can set it to the Documents folder, you can set it to Recents, but you can also choose Other and then from Other I could go ahead choose that Project A folder and now you can see New Finder Window Show Project A. So anytime I go in the Finder to New Finder Window it jumps right to Project A. Now it would be nice if you could customize the Go menu here and add a folder or two into this list, but you can't. However, there is something called Go to Folder here and Shift Command G is the shortcut. A lot of people like to use this when they like to type in the path to a folder. To get to the Project A folder, I could type out the path to it, which would start with a tilde, which represents the home folder, and then /documents/Project A. And now I can hit Go and it goes to that folder. Now that's not very quick to do at all. But the next time I use this, Shift Command G to get there, you can see it appears there as the last one I selected. And I could just hit return for go. So anytime I want to jump to it, I can do Shift Command G, return, and it goes there. If you look here, you'll see that there's actually a list of the five most recent folders. To get to that list, when you first bring this up, all you need to do is hit down arrow and you could go to the one you want and then hit return to jump to it. So I can jump to the documents folder like that. So even if it's not the top choice there, you could still use it if it's one of the five most recent. And this also works in save and open dialogs. So if I go to save this text edit document, I can do Shift Command G and it brings this up. Now I can down arrow to the one I want, hit return, and I jump to that folder. Now you can also use Automator to create a shortcut to go to this folder. An advantage of this is you can set a keyboard shortcut for it. So let's go into Automator here. I'm going to create a new quick action. And then first thing I'm going to do is get specified finder items right there. And I'm going to add this finder location. So let's go right to the Project A folder here. I'll add it and you can see it shows the specified item is Documents Project A. Now I'm going to add Open Finder Items right there underneath it. And set it to default application, and since it's a folder, that would be the finder. I'm going to set the input to no input and have it work in any application. Now when I run this, it will open up a new finder window with Project A. Perfect. So now I could save this and let me just call it go to Project A and save it out. Now I can quit Automator. Now after a few seconds, if I look under Finder Services, I'll notice it there, go to Project A. I could set a keyboard shortcut for this by going to System Preferences and then Keyboard Shortcuts, App Shortcuts, and I'll hit the plus button and I'll do a shortcut for all applications, go to Project A, set a keyboard shortcut for it. Let me do Shift Command Option G and add it. Now when I look under Services, you could see Shift Command Option G is go to Project A. So I can use that keyboard shortcut and the first time I do it, it'll ask for permission. But you can see it opens it up. So now anywhere I am, like say I'm here in TextEdit, I can use that keyboard shortcut and the first time I have to give permission for that app and it opens up that folder. The next time I do it in that app, the keyboard shortcut just quickly opens up the folder. Now there's another way to add a keyboard shortcut to go to this folder. If you look under Go, there's a Recent Folders submenu. And of course, this being an important folder, it's certainly going to be in the Recent Folders list. Usually there are 10 items in there, though you can customize that. Well, it's not super convenient to go to Go, Recent Folders, and then find that folder. But since it's a menu item, you can add a keyboard shortcut just like we did before. So let's go to System Preferences and then Keyboard, Shortcuts, and then App Shortcuts. Let's add it for the exact name of that menu, which is also the exact name of that folder, like that. And then we'll set the keyboard shortcut to something like Control Option Command P and add it. And now we can look in the Go menu under Recent Folders and see the shortcut there. So as long as this folder appears in this list, that keyboard shortcut will be assigned to it. If it drops off this list for some reason because it's not one of the 10 most recent, then you just need to use it again so it appears in the Recents list and the keyboard shortcut will automatically come back. So I can just do Control Option Command P and you can see it opens up the Project A folder there without me having to create anything in Automator. So here's one of the most interesting ways to quickly access that folder. Say you're always using the print command and then saving as PDFs. A lot of people do this as a regular task constantly throughout the day. They create a PDF, save as PDF. Well, then you would have to go and choose that folder if you're saving the documents into that folder. Well, if you look at the bottom of this menu here, there's something called Edit Menu. You go to that and you see Printing Workflows. And you can hit the plus button and you can add as a printing workflow that location. So in this case, I'm going to add the Project A folder. You can just go into it or select it like that. Hit Open and you can see Project A is added here. I'll hit OK. Now under this PDF menu, if I look here, I can see Project A. What happens if I select that? Well, it instantly saves a PDF of whatever I was trying to print. So now when I look in Project A, I can see there is the PDF version of that untitled document. And that works anywhere that you could print. So for instance, here I am in Mail. I could go File, Print, or Command P and then select the Project A folder there. And now if I look there, I can see a PDF of that email message. So the last one I want to show you involves the Spotlight menu. This is when you hit Command Space. And of course you can search for anything. So I can search for Project A and I'll see it come up as a result. And you can see it right there. Now this is where it's important to have a pretty unique name for the folder. Project A, I had to type out the whole word Project Space A. And you can see I also have a lot of other folders called Project A in other locations. But if I were to go and name this something really unique, so now I can type Command Space, start typing the name of the folder, and since it's so unique I don't even have to get that far. Three characters is all I need and it appears, and I hit return and now it opens up that folder. And that works wherever I am. So I could be working here in TextEdit for instance and I can hit Command Space, type WOM and hit return, and it will jump to the folder in the Finder even though I was in TextEdit when I hit Command Space. So each one of these different methods has its advantages and disadvantages. Hopefully one or more of them is going to be useful to you if you've got a single folder that you use all the time. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.